But perfect love casts out fear, for fear has to do with punishment. And whoever fears has not reached perfection in love. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Say yes. Yes, we lift our hands before you. Yes, we clap our hands before you. We thank you for every day of this week. We thank you, God, for the mercies that greeted us, God. We thank you for those mercies today, Most High God, through Yeshua. We thank you for the perfecting work of your love in each and every one of us. Yes, Holy Spirit, you are always welcome here, Ruach HaKodesh. Manifest in each and every one of us. Revive, renew. Whatever it is we need in body and spirit, impart to us this day, Most High God. El Olam, God everlasting, we thank you for the finished works that we all live in and on, the finished works of Jesus, our Messiah. And it is in that matchless name I do pray. All God's people say,
amen.
Amen. I thought when things couldn't get stranger, they got stranger. And I found myself once again saying, what is wrong? God, what is wrong? What is wrong with us? Not what's wrong with them or those. What's wrong with us? And God said, you haven't matured in your understanding of love. And only a maturing love can remove fear. So we are in a country with a lot of scaredy cats. A lot of people who are just afraid. I don't know how many of you tune into my Sunday morning live feed on Facebook, but I go every Sunday morning, I go on and say good morning and make them aware of what's coming in the sermon. I talked about this mature love. See, if you refuse to mature in Christ Jesus, we know what happens when you keep giving the baby milk instead of forcing the baby to have some food. They get what we call milk teeth. We've discussed this. That means their teeth are good for nothing. They shatter. They break. God is wanting, especially Christians in America, to have a refining time of renewal and maturity. Everyone's afraid they're going to be punished in this country. We're going to be punished with more taxes. We're going to be punished by losing access to our insurance. We're just going to be punished. We're going to be punished because people are going to remind us that we have a history that we've never apologized for. And we know what the remedy is for that. It's the same old remedy we've heard. Go back. There is no fear in love. There is no fear in love. So what are we preaching, preachers, Facebook family? What are we preaching to people? That all of the believers in this country walk around so afraid. I'm afraid to be progressive because then they may not understand my conservative tendencies. I'm being biblical here. I have to make that clear now every Sunday. I'm being biblical. Jesus didn't care what your voting prowess was or would be. Jesus did not care. He strutted himself down the street, went into people's houses with children who had died in bed, mothers ill, even walked himself up into the graveyard. Jesus wasn't afraid of a graveyard. I'll tell you what, if we had to put on a secret ballot, how many of you would go into the graveyard at midnight by yourself? Patty would. Benay would. Come on, Shay, now. Most believers would be like, why? Explain to me the significance. Instead of admitting that over the years, what has been sown into them about a graveyard is fear. Next slide. What's ailing us are our fears and our phobias. And when you read this text, love and fear are said the same amount of times. So what's it going to be? Are you going to be afraid or you're going to be loved? Christians have to, what I saw was fear all week. Just raw fear. And I found myself, again, needing to go to Sam's. At the time, it's the most busiest because I don't go in the crowds. And it's not that I'm not afraid. I just don't want to have to witness something because people are going crazy. And most preachers are not addressing the crazy in the country. We're holding it up. What are you afraid of? Because if you're afraid of something, you know, people for 8 years were afraid of Barack Obama, who probably did more things that we as a congregation would be against. Fears and phobias. It sounds like I'm going into the Twilight Zone. Welcome to the fears and phobias of Christian people. That's where we're living. If you look at where Jesus went, we can just look at the Son of the Living God. Jesus would come up against the religious leaders, and you know when they walked in church, they'd be like, that doggone, that joker here is teaching. He's here teaching. He's got the nerve to come up to you. I'm not afraid of you. It should not be about my Father's business. See, the thing is, we won't even go where others are that we find fearful. God has made me go. Now you know you can't afford the salmon over there. You have to go to Sam's where you can afford it. Because you have to take your non-fearful self in so people can see what it's like not to be afraid. And I had the best conversation I've had in a long time standing there waiting for some chicken too while I was there. Fears and phobias. Next slide. See, the word used in Greek is phobos, which America uses as phobia. It's the same word, saints. Are you getting that? That's it. You have a phobia. The problem is you have a phobia and you don't have agape. John says you need to get rid of all your phobias. You're afraid to get a shot? You're afraid to go to the dentist? What are you fearful of? What things were you socialized to be fearful about? Next slide. See, I told on Facebook how I was always taught this is in the black community now. All white people had knives. You can't use their combs. You can't use a brush. You don't put their hats on. Nothing. That's how I was taught in Rinky Dink, Conover, North Carolina. My grandparents raised 8 kids, but they were not going to school with Caucasian people. They went to all black schools. So that act of love of forcing us to go to school together made them see that they had taught their kids to be afraid of Caucasian hair. Y'all remember the story of the girl that kept flipping her hair on my desk? I calmly took my scissors out and cut it off. That was a phobia that had been put in me. I got kicked out of school, everything, and got a spanking. Her parents thought I had lost my mind. But my grandparents put a fear in me. Now, baby, when you go to school, don't use a white person's comb. And Linda, you know I'm telling the truth. Is that not North Carolina backwards teaching? It is. I was backwards as two left shoes. And I acted on that. My cousin and I one time swore we saw lice on this girl. It was dander. Tore up the classroom. Now she, basically you're saying what people are saying to somebody. Unclean, unclean. I had been taught that. And my grandmother and grandfather had to rethink that. Well, you know, we better stop saying that. That girl took it to heart. The intense fear of a particular object that really was harmless. There was nothing wrong with her hair. nothing that people have phobia about. Sometimes our little kinky curly, there's nothing wrong with your hair. Social phobias, the fear of embarrassment in front of people. How many of you have that dream where all of a sudden you are standing there with all the people you know and love and you have no clothes on? You wake up going, oh, thank God that was a dream. Then you find yourself standing somewhere and you're totally embarrassed, stripped naked. People know exactly who you are and how you are. I will tell you what, the smartest people I saw this week were standing behind the president. Only about three of them joined into that chant. God said, you look at it, look at it. They are walking in love. They're refusing, because of who they support politically, to turn around and do that. You can see some of them go. They froze, rightfully so. So agoraphobia, characterized as being in places or circumstances that prove to be difficult or humiliating to escape. I bet if I were a betting person, I bet they would have to pay them a little bit more money to stand on that riser the next time. It's a phobia. Historically, my husband reminded me, when the Chinese people came to this country, the same thing happened. They're taking our jobs. That's not love. If we're going to be a Christian nation, don't function in fear. If you're doing your job and doing it well, should you not be able to go to the throne of grace and say, Lord, help me to hold out? Hey, yes. But if you have a fear of other people, that's called a phobia. In Greek, that is what it is. It is a phobia. And not to mention all the phobias just within the African American community. There's a phobia if you're too light. There's a phobia if you're too dark. There's a phobia if your hair is a 4C hair. That means your hair that is low porosity, of which I have. I went to look at what Becky told me to look at last week. Haitians, Dominicans use the same thing, fear of other human beings. I can't let them come close. I can't let them into my community. What you're really saying is, God, I can't let love come that close. I can't just pull down the walls and love people who aren't like me and look like me and believe like me. God, you're asking too much for me to love that way. Do you want to exist in your phobia? Last time I checked, you can check Daniel and Revelation. Fearful folks do not get in. I don't know about you, but the people in my family who have been fearful, they would scream, knock over tables, people's lamps fall. It's like, look, get out of here, please. Something dropped. It's like, calm down. Do you think we're going to be sitting at the table eating and somebody, oh, I heard something move. You're in heaven. You're going to hear everything move. This is where you cannot exist. God brought me back to this text. I was going to go into prayer. God said, no, my people are fearful. My people have all these phobias, whatever your phobia is. Sometimes it begins here and something just builds on it, and you don't even get to where that hole was first dug. You're just fearful, and then you end up doing something stupid the way I did as a little girl. Cut off somebody's hair. Because everybody said Caucasian people had likes. At Facebook, I do want you to hear that. Because there are children who are being raised in all different type of ways. See, what the Creator wants to do, the love of God in us, when it begins to manifest, you should be able to go anywhere and be okay. Guess what? As a parent, That wasn't easy. At 6 weeks, I wasn't giving B'nai to anybody. Because I didn't know if they would just love her the way I loved her. I didn't know if they would kiss her little face the way I kissed her. I didn't know if they would be meticulous about cleaning and doing all these things. And I wanted to make sure, but now, 3 years later, God said, okay, she has to go to school. No, I don't know those people. It was a phobia that I thought someone was going to hurt my child because I had been hurt as a little girl. It was just a phobia. B'nai didn't cry. B'nai was always a little girl. Bye. See you this afternoon. Monica cried. It was another phobia that if my child was not right in my sight, something may happen to her that was out of my control. That's fear, and that means no trust in God. If you're that afraid, you can't trust God to do a thing. If you trust God and the love of God is filling your heart, you know God's going to protect your child. After all, God's been protecting us in all of our little crazy ways. I look about back at the thing from North Carolina, and Linda, how did we make it? I'm sure Patty and Paul can give you stories from Indiana. Everyone will have a story from where they came from, the different phobias. You can't escape this one. God wants you to get this. Next slide. There is no fear in love. What are you afraid of? If you're afraid of something, you need to find it. You need to infuse it with love. There is no phobias in love. If the love of God, this is agape love right here, is in you, you shouldn't have a phobia. If you do, you need to allow the Spirit to highlight it to get it out of you. Perfect love drives out fear. God's love drives out fear. What are we afraid of? What, as Americans, exactly what are we afraid of? You're afraid you won't get the next house, the next car. You're afraid you won't get to dine the way you've been dining. Or your fear smaller than that? You're just afraid to go to the mailbox because you don't know what's coming that day? That's societal phobias that get put on us. I've gone to the mailbox knowing what's coming and went proudly. Looked at it, still can't pay. You get worried till you're in hives and everything. And at some point, you have to give your phobia over to God's love. Period. Whatever it is, fear has to do with punishment. Do you know there are studies done that say that black people are the most fearful people in the world? We're afraid that people are going to call us lazy, so we don't do certain things. Sometimes we overwork ourselves because people call us lazy, family. We're afraid that, you know, we don't get the hair right. We won't be accepted into the job because laws were passed against black women wearing their hair the way they wear it. Black men, they had to pass laws so you didn't have to shave, so you didn't break out. Black people are some of the most fearful people, afraid people in the world. And you wonder why the majority of us end up getting on dialysis. Spiritually, kidneys represent
fear.
The area of fear. Yes. Fear. And we're not alone. Because if you walk in one, it's just as many Caucasian people there. What are they afraid of? Because at the end of the day, wherever your phobia takes you, you usually end up sitting beside them what you're afraid of. That's crazy, isn't it? You just have to sit for how many hours beside of the one thing you've been taught things about that are untrue. The church has to start unteaching certain things. Black people, you are not cursed because of Noah. That's a lie. You are not cursed because of Noah. That's a lie. That he cursed his son's grandkids. That's a lie. You are not cursed. You are a blessed and highly favored people. No other group on this earth could have endured and continue to endure what we endure and survive. And really act like we got some sense. It's the most shocking thing when people say, oh, they're so articulate and professional.
Oh, you're so soft.
How do you get it curly? The same way you do, jail. Jail. The one who fears is not made in perfect love. Hear me, Beth Salem Facebook family. The one who fears, you're not made in perfect love. It's the word of God. If you are in that perfecting love, you may have started off being afraid of some things. I used to be afraid to sleep in the dark up until I was married. Kenny will tell you now, even the lights on the TV, I'm trying to put some, I need darkness, everybody, darkness, so I can sleep. I was so fearful. And one of the things when I read that fearful people do not get into the kingdom of God, I was like, oh, Jesus, I won't be going. I had to work that out. God, help me. Help me work out being afraid of being in the dark. What is that about? I was brought up poor. It took me all the way back to being in the bed as a little girl one time. And hear me, a rat got on my bed. So I said, if I sleep with the lights on, he was creeping in the dark. See, I'm being real about this. That gave me a phobia. Perfect love had to clean all of that up. It's okay. You can sleep with the lights off. Unless it's one of those rats from sci-fi, you should be able to handle it, baby. We love because God first loved us. You don't have a right, whoever you are, a preacher in the pulpit today, an elder supporting deacons, you do not have a right to tell people not to love. I'm talking to Christians now. You don't have a right not to love. Now, we can point out sometimes, that was not nice. And that person, well, really? It took years for God to say that. You know what? You've never done a full repentance on cutting that girl's hair. Cut it off. I thought I repented when I was hopping around, my grandmother was whooping me. It was about how have you been socialized? Spend time this week. Go back in your mind. What did Mama and Papa and Auntie them put in your head that caused you to have a phobia? I know people who tell stories about Grandpa coming to visit, and Grandpa would give all the grandchildren a dollar. But when he got to the dark skinned grandbabies, he gave them a quarter. That gives you a phobia. That really happened in the African-American community. If we deal with what we need to deal with, we will be able to love better and show forth the perfected love that's in us. So I'm talking to the African-American Christian community and all of the other community. I know the phobias that are in my community. I may not know all of the phobias in another community. But I know if they're in ours, they're in others. And we have to start right here getting rid of those phobias. Because God is so wanting to fill us constantly with that perfected love. If you don't know God in this way, go watch what is called My Grandmother in the Closet, Becky.
Black Grandmother in the Closet.
Black Grandmama in the Closet. into fallen systems that make us fall even further in how we see one another. If you have to get the perfected love, if you get it, you'll walk up in the graveyard, noonday, midnight. You'll walk anywhere. I used to be afraid to walk outside by myself in the dark because they used to make me go get sodas at midnight. One little lady in the neighborhood had a drink machine. I'm being honest. Examine yourself. What is your phobia? Bring it to God. Bring it to God. What is the one thing that you think if you stood up and did, you would be so ashamed? Take that to God, the one who has the perfecting love that can go in and help you work that out within. And trust me, if you start working it out within, you will be different without. Because the change has to happen on the inside. My grandmother used to say, well, she put all that stuff on and makeup, and she's still ugly. I used to be like, man, oh, that's so mean. And my mother just stand right there. She'd go and say, hey, Lucille, you got a hole in your stockings. Grandma said, that ugly. She'd be like, that's just ugly. She finds something every week to say about me. And I used to think, oh, but she's so beautiful. And you start realizing, yeah, but every time she came close to someone, she had to show them what they didn't have compared to her and how they could, her beauty was superficial. Don't let your Christianity be superficial. That's what's happening. If your Christianity is not rooted in the finished works of Jesus that brings in the perfecting love of God, you're playing a game, not on God, believers, on yourself. The game is on you. If you want to be in the cut with God and able to see what's going on, allow the perfected love to do the work. Some of us stop the work. Let the work continue. You will be okay. I've made it so far, and I will tell you, well, I won't put Linda in this one. I'm from North Carolina. We can be as backwards as they can be. Backwards. A lot of that had to come out of me before God could put me anywhere. Because then I just spread the ignorance. God, I thank you for your perfecting love. I thank you that we have access to your perfecting love. I thank you. I thank you, God, for every heart and mind here today. I thank you for every heart and mind on Facebook. This day, God, continue as you always have to do the perfecting work in your people. But God, awaken those who are your children who have been anesthetized to your ways, God. Show them what their phobias are, God. And then give them deliverance as only you can give, God. I thank you for your love and your truth that is in Christ Jesus. All God's people say, amen. Amen. Facebook family, thank you for joining us. I will also post this to YouTube. If you do not follow us, like and follow. You can go to Charlotte Pastor Caldwell on YouTube, like and follow. I do pray that this has given you a sense of what to look at. Because all this week, I had to look at all those different phobias God delivered me from. Take time to look at yourself and find out what phobias you have, also known as fear. Love you guys. I'll see you later this week.